Hello everyone, in this video we'll do our daily current affairs analysis of our news items of 7th October 2021. So first topic in news is the Interpol. So why it is in news? The Interpol has launched an online campaign to apprise people of major cyber threats to help them protect their computer systems, networks and personal information from cyber criminals. The 3-week campaign from October 4 to 22 would be run primarily through social media. Objective of the campaign, with cyber threats becoming increasingly sophisticated in addition to increased levels of remote work and dependence on digital devices, the campaign will focus on ransomware, online scams and phishing, and business email compromise. What is Interpol? So it is an 194 member intergovernmental organization with the headquarters in Lyon, France, formed in 1923, and it's known as Interpol from 1956. So India joined it in 1949 and is one of the oldest members. So Interpol declared global policing goals include promoting border integrity worldwide, protection of vulnerable communities, securing a cyber space for people and businesses, and curbing illicit markets, supporting environment security, and also promoting global integrity. So these are the various Interpol notices. You can have a look at them. Next is the, what is the Interpol General Assembly? So it is an Interpol, the supreme governing body, and comprises representatives from all of its member countries, meets annually with the sessions lasting approximately 4 days to vote on activities and policies of the Interpol. Each member is represented by one or more delegates who are chiefs of law enforcement agencies, which also elects the members of the Interpol Executive Committee, which is the governing body which provides guidance and direction in between the sessions of the assembly. So the prelims important topics are about the fugitive economic offender, what is Interpol, various notices issued, and overview of the Interpol's crime program. Source of this news is The Hindu. You can read the original article. Next is the coal crisis in India, whose background is that India is the second largest importer, consumer and producer of coal and has the world's fifth largest reserve. It mainly imports from Indonesia, Australia and South Africa. So how bad is the situation? The situation is touch and go and could be uncomfortable for up to 6 months. The coal stocks at its thermal power plants can supply just few days of fuel. On October 1, the power ministry said that the 135 thermal power plants in the country had only an average of about 4 days of coal stock left. So reason for the shortage: heavy September rains in coal mining areas hit production and delivery, and plants failed to build up their stocks pre-monsoon. Diamond had outstripped supply despite increased buying from Coal India. Impact of the shortage: if industries face electricity shortages, it could delay India's economic reopening. Some businesses might downscale production. India's population and underdeveloped energy infrastructure will mean the power crisis could hit long and hard. But next, Coal India and NTPC Limited are working to raise output from mines. Government is trying to bring more mines on stream to boost the supply. India will need to amp or increase its import despite the financial cost. So recent reforms in the coal sector: commercial mining of coal allowed, with 50 blocks to be offered to the private sector. Entry norms will be liberalized, as it has done away with the regulation requiring power plants to use washed coal. Coal blocks to be offered to private companies on revenue sharing basis in place of fixed cost. Coal gasification, liquefaction to be incentivized through rebate in revenue share. Coal bed methane extraction rights to be auctioned from Coal India's coal mines. Challenges ahead: coal is the most important and abundant fossil fuel in India. It accounts for 55% of the country's energy needs. So the country's industrial heritage was built upon indigenous coal. So the current per capita commercial primary energy consumption in India is about 350 kg per year, which is well below that of developed countries. So considering the limited reserve potentiality of petroleum and natural gas, eco-conservation restriction on hydel project and geopolitical perception of nuclear power, coal will continue to occupy center stage of India's energy scenario. So prelim shortlink topics are about the NCI, key features and types of coal, what is coal gasification, how is it done, what are the byproducts, benefits of gasification, what is underground coal gasification, what is coal liquefaction, and benefits of liquefaction. Source of this news is the Indian Express. You can read the original article. Next is anti-malarial vaccine Mosquirix. Mosquirix, which has a trade name, which has a original name RTS, SASO1, RTS.S. Trade name Mosquirix has been recently endorsed by the WHO. It is the first and the only vaccine which has the capability of significantly reducing malaria. About Mosquirix, so vaccine acts against falciparum, the most deadly malaria parasite globally and the most prevalent in Africa. It is also the first malaria vaccine to be introduced by three national ministries of health through their childhood immunization programs, Ghana, Kenya and Malawi. So about malaria, it is a life-threatening disease caused by parasites that are transmitted to people through the bites of infected female Anopheles mosquitoes. So malaria burden across the world. Highest is in Africa, where countries like Nigeria, Congo, Tanzania account for almost 50% of the global deaths. So in 2019, about 4 lakh people, and particularly the children aged under 5 years, die the most. So in India, in 2019, it had an estimated 5.6 million cases of malaria compared to about 20 million cases in 2020. So countries that have eliminated malaria, with countries having at least 3 consecutive years of 0 indigenous cases of malaria, they can apply for WHO certification of malaria elimination. In the last 2 decades, 11 countries have been certified so, and the latest include the El Salvador. And this is the complete list. You can have a look. Okay. So next is the challenges ahead. So the latest vaccine is considered only the first step towards the effective immunization of the global population against malaria. And it is effective in only 30% of the cases. And the quest for more effective vaccines is still underway. So reasons for the failure to develop a malaria vaccine so far. So the complexity of the life cycle of the malaria causing parasite, a part of which is spent in the human host. These parasites are also able to hide inside human cells to avoid being recognized by the immune system, creating further challenges. Lack of funding and interest in developing a malaria vaccine. The vaccine manufacturers have little incentive for malaria vaccines. So prelims shortening topics are difference and examples of various diseases caused by virus and bacteria. Malaria causes and treatment. About WHO certification process. Overview of WHO World Malaria Report 2020. Source of this news is The Hindu. You can read the original article here. So next is the UN peacekeepers. Important for GS paper 2. Topic is important international institutions, agencies and fora, their structure mandate. So why it is news? A total of 836 troops from the Indian Army serving with the UN peacekeeping mission in South Sudan have been awarded the United Nations Medal for their services to ensure durable peace in the world's youngest country. So what is the peacekeeping and why it is significant? So United Nations peacekeeping is a joint effort between the Department of Peace Operations and the Department of Operational Support. Every peacekeeping mission is authorized by the Security Council. Financial resources are the collective responsibility of the UN member states. According to a UN charter, every member state is legally obligated to pay their respective share for peacekeeping. So composition, they are often known as blue berets or blue helmets because of the blue berets or helmets worn by them, and include soldiers, police officers and civilian personnel, and the contribution is on a voluntary basis. Next is the civilian staff of peace operations are international civil servants recruited and deployed by the UN Secretariat. So it is guided by 3 basic principles, which include consent of the parties, impartiality and non-use of force except in self-defense and defense of the mandate. So global partnership, UN peacekeeping is a unique global partnership, brings together the General Assembly, Security Council, Secretariat, troop and police contributors and the host governments in a combined effort to maintain international peace and security. Its strength lies in the legitimacy of the UN Charter and in the wide range of contributing countries that participate and provide precious resources. Brilliant shortlink topics are who funds peacekeeping operations, role of UNSC, composition of peacekeepers, why peacekeepers are called as blue helmets, guiding principles of UN peacekeeping, ongoing peacekeeping missions. Source of this news is The Hindu. You can read these original articles to get further clarity on the topic. Next is the new tiger reserve announced in Chhattisgarh. So the National Tiger Conservation Authority has approved the Chhattisgarh government's proposal to declare the combined areas of the Guru Ghasi Das National Park and Tamor Pingla Wildlife Sanctuary as a tiger reserve. The new reserve is located in the northern part of the state, bordering Madhya Pradesh and Jharkhand. This will be the fourth tiger reserve in Chhattisgarh after the Udamti Sita Nadi, Ashnak Mar and Indravati reserves. So the Guru Ghasidas National Park was the last known habitat of the Asiatic cheetah in the country. So how is a tiger reserve created? The approval is granted by the NTCA under Section 3851 of the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. The state government shall, on the recommendation of the Tiger Conservation Authority, notify an area as a tiger reserve. So it is taken from Indian Express. This is the original article. Next is the Jim Corbett National Park. Brilliant specific topic. So it is in news because the United Union Minister of State for Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Ashwini Kumar Chaubey, has proposed to change the name of Corbett National Park to Ram Ganga National Park. So about the Jim Corbett National Park, it is located in Nainital district of Uttarakhand. The park encompasses the Patli Dune Valley formed by the Ram Ganga River. So it was established in 1936 as the Haley National Park to protect the endangered Bengal tiger. So it is named after Jim Corbett, who played a key role in its establishment. It is the oldest national park in India. It was the first area to come under the Project Tiger initiative in 1973. So this is the original article. You can have a look. Next is Good Samaritan Scheme. So the Union Government has launched a scheme for Good Samaritan. The scheme will be implemented from October 15. So under the scheme, anyone who saves the life of a road accident victim by rushing them to a hospital within the golden hour will get a cash reward of ₹5,000. Each Good Samaritan will also receive a certificate of appreciation. An individual could be awarded a maximum of 5 times in a year. The ministry also said there will be 10 national level awards each year for the worthiest Good Samaritans, who would be selected from all those who have been awarded during the whole year, and they would be given an award of ₹1 lakh each. If more than one Good Samaritan saves the life of more than one victim, the amount of award would be ₹5,000 per victim saved, subject to a maximum of ₹5,000 per Good Samaritan. Source of this news is The Hindu. You can read this original article to get further clarity on this topic, on this news. So thanks a lot for watching the analysis video. Have a nice day.